Christmas from community preschool and childcare. In years past, we have had our annual Christmas pageant with all the children participating, but due to COVID, we have to do things differently. So the children are celebrating the birth of Jesus in their classrooms through art, through stories, through activities. But we do have one class that wanted to sing a couple of their favorite songs from the Christmas pageant for you. So here is our preschool class with Miss Janet and Miss Sandra. Thanks.
My name is Pastor Esta Rosario, and on behalf of Woodmar United Methodist Church, I welcome you to our online Christmas Eve worship experience. It feels so weird not to be worshiping in person on this holiest of nights, but we also know that the holiness of this night does not depend on any one of us. We pray that this Christmas celebration is a sacred, holy, and joyful celebration for all. We'll be celebrating Holy Communion a little later in worship, so I invite you to hit pause and go to your kitchen and collect some elements for communion: bread, crackers, juice, tea, coffee, water, whatever you would like to use. And I'd also like to invite you to share generously for our Christmas Eve offering. This offering will go for the Bishop's Children's Fund, the Bishop's Christmas offering, and it is used to help children around the world and in local communities. So if you'd like to donate electronically, you can go to our website at www.woodmarumc.org. and make a note that it's for the Christmas Eve offering, or if you'd like to mail in a check, just mentioned Christmas Eve offering, and it will go for the Bishop's Children's Fund. So let's worship the babe born this night that came to save us. Merry Christmas.
Our hopes move us. Advent love leads us. Advent joy stirs us.
Advent peace stills us, that we might affirm our King Jesus.
It is time we set flame to this Advent affirmation by lighting the Christ candle.
We believe that Jesus is the Son of God. He was born of the Virgin Mary in Bethlehem of Judea. He was the long-awaited Messiah, whose coming was prophesied. The same Jesus lives today in our hearts. He deserves our highest loyalty and total commitment. In Jesus Christ, our hope is fulfilled. Our love is consummated. Our joy is complete, and our peace is sealed.
Rejoice, a Savior is born.
The Savior is born indeed. Joy to the world.
Thank you.
First lesson comes from the book of Isaiah, chapter 9, verse 2 and 6 through 7. The prophet announces the birth of a king to people in darkness. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in a land of deep darkness, on them light has shined. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness from this time onward and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this.
Oh. The second lesson is from Luke 1, 26 to 35 and 38. The angel Gabriel announces to the Virgin Mary that she will give birth to God's promised Son, whose kingdom shall never end. In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary, and he came to her and said, "Greetings, favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was much perplexed by his words and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. And the Lord God will give him the throne of his ancestor David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there shall be no end." Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I am a virgin?" The angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be holy. He will be called Son of God." Then Mary said, "Here am I, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her.
Yeah. third lesson of the night, taken from Luke 2, 1 through 7. In those days, a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be enrolled. This was the first enrollment where Quirinius was governor of Syria, and all went to be enrolled, each to his own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, from the city of Nazareth to Judea, to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be enrolled with Mary, his betrothed, who was with child. And while they were there, the time came for her to be delivered.
How could it be, this baby in my arms, sleeping now so peacefully? The Son of God, the angel said, how could it be? I know he's not my own, not of my flesh, not of my bones. Still, Father, let this baby be the son of my love. Father, show me where I fit into this plan of yours. How can a man be father to the Son of God? Lord, for all my life I've been a simple carpenter. How can I raise a king? How can I raise a king? He looks so small, his face and hands so fair. And when he cries, the sun just seems to disappear. But when he laughs, it shines again. How could it be? Father, show me where I fit into this plan of yours. How can a man be father to the Son of God? Lord, for all my life I've been a simple carpenter. How can I raise a king? How can I raise a king? How could it be, this baby in my arms, sleeping now so peacefully? Son of God, the angel said, how could it be? How could it be?
And there were in the same country shepherds abiding in the field,
keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be unto all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you. You shall find the baby wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill to men. And it came to pass, as the angels were gone away from them into heaven, the shepherds said unto one another, Let us go now even unto Bethlehem, and see this thing which has come to pass, which the Lord has made known unto us. And they came in haste, and they found Mary and Joseph and the baby lying in the manger.
Christmas, boys and girls. I so wish that we could be together this night to celebrate the birth of baby Jesus together. because we have a very special tradition here at Woodmar United Methodist Church. Do you remember what that is? Take a look at the nativity scene. Who is missing? That's right, the baby Jesus. We didn't put the baby Jesus in the manger because he hadn't been born yet, but we get to tonight. And if we were here together, I would ask one of you to place our baby Jesus in the manger, but I'll do it for us. Glory to God in the highest heavens. Our Savior has been born. Merry Christmas. Let us pray. Oh, loving God, we thank you for who you are, and we praise you for all the things that you do in our lives. And most of all, we thank you for the gift of the babe born in Bethlehem who became our Savior. We love you and we love Jesus, and help us to live loving you and loving him. And it's in his name we pray. Amen.
The Shepherd's Witness by glorifying and praising God. When they saw this, they made known what had been told them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, as it had been told them.
You wonder as you watch my face.
In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him, not one thing came into being. What has come into being in him was life, and the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. There was a man sent from God, whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify to the light, so that all might believe through him. He himself was not the light, but he came to testify to the light, the true light, which enlightens everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world came into being through him, yet the world did not know him. He came to what was his own, and his own people did not accept him. But to all who received him, who believed in his name, he gave power to become children of God, who were born not of blood, or of the will of the flesh, or of the will of man, but of God. And the Word became flesh and lived among us, and we have seen his glory, the glory as of a Father's only Son, full of grace and truth.
Oh.
Christ our Lord invites to his table all who love him, who earnestly repent of their sin and seek to live in peace with one another. Therefore, let us confess our sin before God and one another. Let us pray. Merciful God, we confess that we have not loved you with our whole heart. We have failed to be an obedient church. We have not done your will. We have broken your law. We have rebelled against your love. We have not loved our neighbors, and we have not heard the cry of the needy. Forgive us, we pray. Free us for joyful obedience through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Please take a moment now for silent prayers of confession. Please take a moment to wrap up your prayers. Please look at me. Hear the good news. Christ died for us while we were yet sinners. That proves God's love toward us. In the name of Jesus Christ, you are forgiven. In the name of Jesus Christ, you are forgiven. Glory to God. Amen. And now is the time, if we were all together, where we would offer one another signs of reconciliation and love. So I invite you now to, if you're with someone in your home, to pass the peace of Christ. If you live alone, then hit pause and call a friend and pass the peace of Christ. Everywhere to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. You created light out of darkness and brought forth life on the earth. You formed us in your image and breathed into us the breath of life. When we turned away and our love failed, your love remained steadfast. You delivered us from captivity, made covenant to be our sovereign God, and spoke to us through your prophets. In the fullness of time, you gave your only Son, Jesus Christ, to be our Savior. And at his birth, the angels sang, "Glory to you in the highest, and peace to your people on earth." And so, with your people on earth and all the company of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Holy are you, and blessed is your Son, Jesus Christ. As Mary and Joseph went from Galilee to Bethlehem and there found no room, so Jesus went from Galilee to Jerusalem and was despised and rejected. As in the poverty of a stable, Jesus was born, so by the baptism of his suffering, death, and resurrection, you gave birth to your church, delivered us from slavery to sin and death, and made with us a new covenant by water and the Spirit. As your word became flesh, born of woman, on that night long ago, so on the night in which he gave himself up for us, he took bread, gave thanks to you, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." When the supper was over, he took the cup, gave thanks to you, gave it to his disciples and said, "Drink from this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." And so, in remembrance of these your mighty acts in Jesus Christ, we offer ourselves in praise and thanksgiving as a holy and living sacrifice in union with Christ's offering for us as we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Pour out your Holy Spirit on all who are worshiping online, and on these gifts of bread and wine, and the gifts of bread and wine in our homes. Make them be for us the body and blood of Christ, that we may be for the world the body of Christ, redeemed by his blood. Make us one with Christ by your Spirit, one with each other, and one in ministry to all the world, until Christ comes in final victory and we feast at his heavenly banquet. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit in your holy church, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. And all God's children say, Amen. And now, being confident that we are the beloved children of God who are called and sent to make a difference in the world, let us pray the prayer of our Lord's heart. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Because there is one loaf, we who are many are one body, for we all partake of the one loaf. The bread which we break is a sharing in the body of Christ. The cup over which we give thanks is a sharing in the blood of Christ. The body of Christ broken for you. Eat and be thankful. The blood of Christ shed for you. Drink and be thankful. Let us pray. Eternal God, we give you thanks for this holy mystery in which you have given yourself to us. Grant that we may go into the world in the strength of your Spirit to give ourselves for others. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. In the world. Yes, that is who we are. So let's live to love, serve, celebrate, and share the good news of Jesus Christ, our Savior, who was born this night in Bethlehem. And may the blessing of God Almighty, God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit be with us all today and remain with us forever. And all God's children say, Amen.